derivative. This is an important application of derivative. And using the application of derivative, here I am going to discuss the how to find out the approximate values of the radical numbers or the exponential numbers using this interesting formula, which already it is discussed in the previous class. Okay, and using this formula, and you can find out the approximate value of such kind of numbers. Okay, we can find out 49.5, what is the exact approximate value of the 49.5 square root up to 3 decimal places. What is the square root of 0.6 up to 3 decimal places? We can find out 0.999 whole to the power 1 by 10 up to 3 decimal places using the formula. And the formula is that all of you know, f of x plus del x is equal to fx plus dy by dx into del x. Is it clear? And this formula already discussed. Okay, this is only the formula where you can find all such kind of problems, okay, in a correct manner. Okay, so let us start. Let's first number, let us find out 49. First number is that 49.5 root over square root of 49.5. okay, so here we have to take that this 49.5 can be written as 49 log 0.5. yes or no? Okay, and you see the 49.49 is a perfect square. Here is perfect square, so you can write 49.5 is equal to 49.0.5 root over. Okay, understand? So let this value, this 49 can be taken as x, and the 0.5 can be taken as del x. Okay, so let x is equal to 49 is equal to x, and 0.5 can be taken as the del x. Small change in the value. Okay, this decimal part 0.5 we can take the del x, right? Okay, then the function y, the y will be x to the power 1 by root over. Okay, because the radical sign is square root sign is there. So if the function is x, then y is equal to function is y is equal to fx is equal to root x, right? Okay, now you can write this here, f of x plus del x is equal to fx plus dy by dx into del x. Okay, so 49.5, this f x plus del x written as 49.5 root over is equal to fx. Fx means what? Fx value, and here you can take the 49 root over 49. Fx value we have taken was x root over, right? And plus d by dx root x, okay, into del x. Is it clear? And that is equal to, here the value of x can be replaced by 49 root over plus d by, okay, let's see, derivative of root x is equal to, all of you know, 2 into square root of x into del x. What is the value of del x? Del x taken value 0.5. Not only in place of del x, write 0.5. Then 49 root over is 7 plus 1 divided by 2 into x is equal to 49, and 49 root over is also 7 into 0.5. And this is also equal to 7 plus 0.5 divided by 2, 7 is 14. 0.5 to the power 14. Now let us divide 0.5 to the power 14. Okay, now 0.5 to the power 14, 0.5 divided by 14. So let us write the zero decimal point. Okay, then after that you have to so let the decimal be separated, so it will be 5, and here put 10, then it will be 50. So it is, you see now 14, 3 is 42. 10 minus 8 is 2 is okay. Then you put the 0. 14, 5 is 70. 0, 1. Again put 0. So 14, 6 is 84. Okay. So it will value will be 0.0356. 0.0356. Right. So it is equal to 7 plus 0.0356. Okay. So this 49.5 root hour is equal to 7 plus 0.0356. Okay. Now, then hence 49.5 finally we got is equal to 7.0356. Okay, and you have to find out the value up to 3 decimal places. In 3 decimal places, you see the digit in the 4th places is 6. So if it is this in the 4th place is 6, we have to add 1 to the previous digit. So 5 plus 1 is 6. Hence we get finally 49.5 root over is equal to 7.036. This is the approximate value of 3 decimal places. Approximate value of 3 decimals. Okay, so this is how you can find out the square root of 49.5 using the formula. This important formula with the help of the derivative. Okay, so you should follow in the similar question also. Okay, let me see the another question is 0.6 root hour. Let me see 0.6 root hour, right? Okay, so we noted here. Okay, okay, let me go to the next questions. Next question. Let me go to the next question. So, second question is that we have to find out 0.6 root over 0.5 plus 0.6. Second question is that we will find out 0.6 root over. Okay, so we can write 0.60. Yes or no? So, 0.60 nearest square, perfect square, we can write 0.64. minus 0.04, and you see 0.64 is a perfect square. Yes or no? Okay, here you take the x value is 0.64 and del x value is minus 0.04. minus sign is coming here, so you take del. Okay, so here you take fx y is equal to fx is equal to x is equal to 0.64 root over, and del x, here del x is equal to, you can take minus 0.04. okay, understand? Now you can use the formula f of x plus del x, which is fx plus dy dx into del x. Okay, so this fx plus del x is 0.6 root over is equal to fx, in place of fx and I get root x plus dy dx root x, this is into del x value minus 0.04, right? And that is equal to 0.64, the value of x is 0.64 plus derivative of root x, we can write 1 upon 2 root x into minus 0.04. is it clear? And that is equal to 0.6 root over 0.8 plus 1 by 2 into root x is 0.8 into minus 0.04, right? Okay, understand? It's okay. Then after that, You see, see here, 0. X can be written is equal to 0.8 plus 1 upon 0.8 into 2, 8 to the 16, 1.6 into, we can write also plus into minus, let us say in the sign, sign will be minus, okay, this will be, and you see now, plus and minus is minus, and this is 0.04 divided by 8 to the 16 is 1.6. So that is equal to 0.8 minus, okay, remove the decimal, it will be 4 by 16. Here in denominator, after decimal point, there is one digit, so write down 1 and give 10. Similarly, here in the numerator, write down 1. Okay, in the numerator, there are two digits in the decimal place, the 1 and 2, so you have to put 20. This is how you have to bring the decimal point. Okay, then you can cancel here, the 425, yeah. Okay, then 25, 28, yeah. And that is equal to 0.8 minus, it will be 25, 28, yeah. Again, you can cancel also 55, yeah. So it will be 1 upon 40. You see here 425 100, then 25 10, 28 16, again 5 25. So in the numerator there is 1 and denominator here is 8, here is 5, so 85 to 40. 0.8. So 0.6 is 0.8 minus 1 by 40, right? Okay, now let us divide 1 by 40, let us divide. So here see, give the decimal point 0, again here 0 and 42 is 80, 0 to 200, 4, 5 is 200. So what is the value? And that will be 0.8 minus 0.025. And after doing minus, we can get the value of 0.6 up to 3 decimal places, okay? Okay, let's see. Let's see, 0.6, I can write root over is equal to, you will divide 0.8, divide, subtract 0.8 and 0.025. Here 010, you do minus sign, 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus 7, it is 7. And 0.0775, so it is 0.775. So this is the value of 0.6, root over is 0.775. Okay, is it clear? Understood? This is the value of the square root of 0.6. So it is an interesting question. You see, you can find out the square root of any number using this interesting formula. Okay, understand? So you have to follow this one, and you see how the numerical expression can be simplified with the easier process and with the help of the most important application of the derivative using the concept of error and application, error and approximation, right? Okay, so shall we move to the next question, which is 0.999. You see. 0.999. Shall we move to the next question? Okay. Note this one. So to understand, 0.6 root over is 0.775. Okay. Okay. Next to the next question. What is the third question? Is there 0.999 root over? 0.999 whole to the power 1 by 10. If the power is 1 by 10, you see. The power is 1 by 10. It means you can find out, evaluate the simplified any number of any power. This is one of the interesting fact. Okay, so application derivative has most usefulness in our numerical solving, simplifying the numerical expression. Okay, let us come to the question number 3, students. Question number 3. Okay, shall we move? So this is dy by dx. Okay, let's see. Question number 3 is that 0.999 over to the power 1 by 10. So power is 1 by 10. Here power is 1 by 10. Let us see the nearest perfect square number is 1. Let us subtract 1.000. 0.999 and subtract 10 minus 9 is 1, 9 minus 0, 9 0, it is 0.001. It means we can write 0.999 4 to the power 1 by 10 can be written. How can you write? 1 minus 0.001 4 to the power 1 by 10. Right, okay, and here you see the value of x is coming. This is x, and this value is del x. Here, in place of x, I can write 1, and in place of del x is minus 0.001. Right, okay, let's proceed to the next. So, here, what happened? We have taken that y is equal to x to the power 1 by 10. Here, the power is 1 by 10, so y is equal to x to the power 1 by 10. And del x we have taken, del x is equal to minus 0.001. So minus sign you have to come, so you have to consider this is us, del x is equal to minus 0.001. Okay, now let us give the formula. F of x plus del x is equal to fx, same formula I am using, dy by dx, this single line formula. Can solve such kind of any difficult question of any exponent. Okay, so that implies you see fx plus del x is 0.999 1 by 10. In fx we can write x to the power 1 upon 10 plus d by dx, in place of x write x to the power 1 by 10 into del x. Right, okay. Then put the values there. Then you have to put the values. That is equal to x to the power 1 by 10. In place of x, I can write 1. In place of y, I can write 1. So 1 to the power 1 by 10 plus, okay, derivative of x to the power 1 by 10 is 1 by 10. X to the power 1 upon 10 minus 1 is equal to minus 9 upon 10. Is it no? This is minus 9 upon 10 into del x value minus 0.001. Yes or no? This value del x is minus 0.001. Let us put the values here. Okay. Then, as a 1 to the power 1 by 10, whatever the values of power 1, the value always 1, all of you know, plus 1 upon 10. Here x value is also 1. 1 to the power minus 1, 9 by 10 into, okay, you can write plus and minus. You can multiply here also. Let us multiply here. This side plus sign into minus sign. It will be minus. After that, 1 by 10 in place of x write 1. Okay. In place of x write, here x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1. Okay. So, into 0.001. Right. Okay. Understand this concept? Clear? Clear? Okay. Okay, next question. So after that you see. Okay, so you see 0.999 4 to the power 1 by 10 is equal to, now 1 minus, is 1 to the power anything, value is always 1. This is 1 by 10 into 0.001, and that is equal to 1 minus 0. It will be 0.001. 0.001 by 10 is 0.001 is equal to, now subtract. Okay, so let us subtract here. 1.0000 and 0.0001, it will be 10 minus 1 9 9 9 9 0.9999. okay, and final got 0.9999, and finally we got 0.999 4 to the power 1 by 10 is equal to 0.9999, and this is the desired value of 0.9999 4 to the power 1 by 10. So you see, you are finding very easy process. You are able to find out the values of the any exponent of any power, okay, in a lucid manner using the concept, only this formula you remember, students. So this formula, remember, f of x plus del x is equal to fx plus dy by dx into del x, okay. So this formula, if you can remember, you can find out the values of any approximation using this formula, okay. I hope and you will find interest in the problem, okay. Understand and solve the different kind of problems which are coming in the MCQ question also. You can do such kind of problem are coming, okay, mostly so in the CBSE paper, okay. So thank you all of you for the class. Thank you once again. See you once again. Bye. Thank you.